dear friends, welcome to the second Prague walkthrough on fictionality, possibility, and reality. The first topic has been, as you know, in full agreement with the title Fictional due to certain volcanic eruptions, which I wouldn't like to describe in detail. This second colloquium has been made possible by the sleeping volcano on island, and we will do our best to make it real with your help. Or at least this concerns the program for Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. The Thursday program is supposed to be in the same mode as the last year colloquium, although the boundary between fiction and reality is extremely thin, as you know. I find this from the correspondence concerning the Thursday program. I received a letter from Alberto Bottolini explaining to me that he cannot give his talk scheduled for Thursday because of his flight, which is a serious reason, of course. Fortunately, no protests came from Prince Mishkin, Max Brod, and Franz Kafka, who are also on the list for Thursday. So, as to Alberto, we have made today a compromise. So the talk on Thursday will be given by his fictional counterpart, is it right? The real Alberto, this one, will give his talk today after real, I suppose, Professor Groleger. And then we would like to invite you to a lunch which is supposed to be good and real. And it should go in the same way until Thursday. The Thursday trip to Karlovy Vary is meant to be obligatory and fictional. But we are supposed to pay for it already on Wednesday, which means that the payment should be real, in cash. If you lose orientation in these subtle distinctions, so then please don't ask me, because I have the same problem, but rather contact our friend Tomáš Podíček, who is somewhere here, who is responsible for the organization in this villa, and he will either know or decide what is fictional and what is real. And who of you is fictional and who is real? So he is the only expert in this field.
You must remember what Kant says about the difference between 100 imaginary and 100 real problems. No difference.
Yeah, but we are going to talk much later, so let's postpone this issue to your talk. Yeah. Now I have the pleasure of introducing to Professor Lubomír Boleger from Prague, who will give the opening and totally real talk with the title Critical Issues in the Theory of Fiction, Possible Worlds, Fictional Worlds, Literary Texts.
So-called philosopher. So those of you who
consider the contact so far between philosophers and those who work in, say, in empirical sciences, and in empirical sciences, and I'm afraid that it has a very general, it's a very general complaint, that these contacts between philosophy and empirical sciences are mostly one-sided or one-directional. The theoreticians in the empirical sciences are usually very well acquainted with philosophy's epistemology, and on the other hand, unfortunately, we are no longer in the period of classical philosophy, where every philosopher had to be also a scientist, or at least a mathematician. So this forum for me is an opportunity to bridge or build a bridge, a parallel bridge, and a two-way bridge between philosophy and those domains of empirical sciences which have been practicing, cultivating the problem of fictionality. In my opinion, and I am speaking as a representative, as I said, of literary fiction and for literary fiction, I think that the problem of literary fiction has to be resolved in the intersection of two major theoretical domains or enterprises, on the intersection of philosophy of language and text theory. I don't claim that this model of this fusion would be valid for or necessary for all fiction research, or research in fiction. Because, in my opinion, fiction is not only, fiction doesn't arise only in literature. I believe that all artistic activities, lyric poetry, drama and theater, film, television, ballet, painting and sculpting, each by its own semiotic means, create or construct fictions. And I also believe that because of that, we have to have a very, very lively, active, interdisciplinary research in order to understand or arrive to a certain synthetic theory of fiction. As you know, I would like now to arrange my talk in a certain narrative. As you know, everything today recently has been going to be narrative, so why not, by putting a narrativist, arrange a presentation in a narrative way. I invite you